forward, and it pays to be ready, saints. Hallelujah. I'm not trying to come down on you, because we all have to get ready. All of us. I'm putting some things together. Just this week I was out, and I said, Lord, let me go on a little fast. Let me pray. Hallelujah. And I was like, Lord, I pray, and I hope I'm doing something that would be pleasing to you. Went to the supermarket. Hallelujah. And this man that didn't know me from Adam said, this is a woman of God. She is sanctified. She is set aside. He said, when she sings, I don't know what he told me about singing. But anyway, folk will get delivered. And he said, you ask me how I know? I'm like, what do you know me? He was like, because I am a minister of God. How many times have you had the opportunity to help build somebody up in one room? We have to stop thinking that God is a God that's just going to bless one at a time. He can bless us corporately. Don't get upset because God is blessing somebody else. Your turn is coming. You serve a great big God. I'm going to get right to wrap it up. But I just wanted to say that Christ called that individual a hypocrite. Now we know what a hypocrite is. Somebody who's a pretender. Hallelujah. They want to find fault in everything you do. Hallelujah. And the Bible said they do the same thing. But even on a larger scale, you ought to make me, you might see a visual, but instead, commentary said this person, it may be spiritual. Oh, folk may not see it, but internally. Amen. I watch on YouTube, it's called The Holy Ghost Enforcers. I don't know if you ever seen it with Lexi, and you know, it's meant to be comical. And she's an old lady who's been in the church for years and always looking to find fault. Hallelujah. And the young people or anybody who's in position. Hallelujah. And she was getting on this young woman because she came from a lifestyle of being a stripper.
Okay?
Not that you shouldn't say something, but when the young lady pulled her money out of and gave it to her, all that other stuff turned around. And she was like, tell me, my friend, no, don't do that, y'all. Oh, we were because folks giving money in church, we taking down from the standard because they may be one of the biggest tithe payers. We take down from the standard. We need to lift the standard. How do we know who you are?
Yes.
Great or small, we all got to give an account at the church.
Right.
And yes, the church needs your money. But if you don't do it, God will send somebody else to do it. I know your people. We will not be held hostage.
Amen.
Because of money.
That's right. Amen.
Hallelujah. The Bible said they had a little splinter, but you have this big old beam hanging out and you won't do nothing with it. Mm-hmm. But you want to help them with their splinter.
That's the church.
Come on now.
Come on. We ought to be happy when folk come in.
Right.
And let the leadership fix them. That ain't your job.
Amen.
That ain't your job. Let the leadership take it to the leadership. They've been dealing with it. They know how to handle it. You may run the person off.
Yeah.
But let's have boundaries in the body of Christ. Let's have boundaries. Those of us who've been here for a while, let's not get so upset when our leadership corrects us.
Right.
They want to see us grow.
Amen.
Nobody wants to be feeding you milk all the time. It's time for you to be eating meat. The Bible said we have need of being taught when we should be teachers.
Yes.
We should be teachers by now. So let's give God a big hand. If you want to go find it in me. Some people asked him, who sinned, his mother or father? And his parents or him. And he said, neither. But it's that the glory of God could be revealed. Sometimes people are going through for God's glory. And we have to be able to properly discern. We have to